Hey guys, welcome to episode number 29 of OG Toys. I'm OG. Today we're doing a special review on LEGO Ninjago. We got Lash's Bite Cycle. It's a 250-piece set. Your set number is 9447. Does come with two minifigs. Unfortunately, neither of which are exclusive to the set. We've seen them before in some other sets. You got Cole ZX and Lasha. Does come with a really cool weapons forge as well. And the awesome detailing on this wicked motorcycle. Now let's take a look at Cole. Now I'll show you some fine details on this black ninja. I'm sure we got a couple of these in your Ninjago collection. I'm surely building up a bit of an army of these guys. I've already got a bit of an army of white ninjas, which actually I don't mind. They look cool guarding Sensei Wu. I got a little display set up with them. They look awesome, actually. And I got a couple of black ninjas, so I'm not complaining about that because it has some great printed detail on his torso. Does come with the awesome silver shoulder pads that have a harness for the two ninja swords that can fit into the back. And you got a little symbol and some printed work on there as well. I love the helmets. I love these new helmets. They come with that silver accent. I think it's a pretty big improvement over the old ones. They have that annoying little clip on the back. And basically you put a weapon attachment to that clip, but it just didn't look as good as this one here. It's nice and clean on the back. And you can remove the helmet, of course, and you got his face. He only has one-sided printing. And I'll show you some more of his printed back. Really nicely done. So there you go. Would have been nice to see maybe another figure, but who else are really going to put in the set besides one of the multicolored ninjas? But still, I really do like this figure. I'm not going to have any complaints about this figure being in the set. And of course, you got Lasha. Now, Lasha is available in a spinner pack as well. It came out a while ago. I was planning on getting that, but once I saw this set was coming, held off. I'm glad I did because the set is awesome. This is probably my second favorite Snake figure. Man, he's just so well done. He's got some great printed work all over his face. Real character to this guy. He's got scratches on his chest. He's missing an eye. He's got his tongue sticking out. He's got a couple red vials there. It could be some snake venom bombs or whatever, but really nicely done figure. He does have some printed work on his hood on the top as well. And he only has the one-sided printed face and some printed work on the back. Very cool figure. Now, the weapons forge. I thought this was quite an interesting piece. Of course, you get some extra weapons. You got a cool design anvil. You got a fire pit over here to heat up your weapons. You got the hammer to pound on the weapons. Cool little saber, spear, and this larger spear. And we got some really nice brick pieces as well. We've seen tons of these in the Lord of the Rings sets. And we see these in a lot of the other kind of Ninjago snake temples and little pieces that come with the vehicle. So love those. Very cool. Gives the pieces some bit more of a realistic look. The brickwork is very well done. And of course, we got the cycle here. Now, I'm a pretty big sucker for motorcycles. I love the way that LEGO designs these motorcycles. The city stuff, we've seen tons of motorcycles and ATVs. They're not too bad. Even the one in the Avengers Captain America set isn't that bad. Same with the Wolverine and the X-Men set. But these are the ones I'm talking about. I love the way they design these sets. You know, there's such attention to detail on these guys and the characteristics. The snake face, to start off with, is awesome. You've seen this in the Rattlecopter and the Fangpire vehicle. It just gives these vehicles such character. It's such a cool look. You got the red eyes, the fangs. This piece here is fantastic. It really gives that eye some definition and form. Unfortunately, all of these pieces here have stickers on them. I really dislike stickers, but I'm going to put them on because it does make the vehicle and sets look a lot better. And you got some purple flames shooting out the exhaust. You got this huge wheel tire in the back. That looks really cool. And you got two small ones that make up the front steering wheel. And this thing does have some articulation in the front end too, which is kind of odd. You can just move that up. Doesn't really do much. not much of a flay feature, but whatever. You do have some flickfire missiles on either side, of course. You got some pigs here to put some weapons. I put some dynamite, and we got a fang blade on this side. And of course, you got this tail. Suitable. It makes sense for a snake vehicle to have a tail. And it's articulated, and you can move it up and down all the way around. Pretty cool. And you got some more stickers here. And in the front part here, and you got a steering mechanism there. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you some of the other motorcycles that Ninjago has incorporated into their line in the past few years. Let's put them back in a cycle here. Let's move this bit out of the way. And I'll show you one of my other favorite vehicles. You got here, you got Kai's Blade Cycle. Another awesome motorcycle. Using the big fat tires for the front and the back. Such a great color scheme with the red, gold, and you got some stickers in the front. Of course, it has a bit of a play feature. You pop that button there, and you got some blades to come out and do some more damage to your snake man. Very cool. Of course, it comes with Kai, one of my favorite ninjas, in the red. Now, both vehicles are almost the same lengthwise. Lash's cycle is just a bit longer, I mean about an inch or so, but the tail, of course, makes this vehicle a lot bigger. Still, great motorcycles. And then we got one more for you. This is probably one of my first Ninjago sets I ever bought. I just thought this was really interesting design work. And this is the chopper, the skull chopper. Great little skull on the front end there. You got the wicked skeleton warrior on the back. He's got these exhaust ports with the flame shooting out, the big thick tire in the front. And again, this one has two tires that make up the front steering tire. So that's kind of cool. Great detailed work on this thing as well. And you have a play feature, you just pull back on this, and this shoots forward and smashes your Ninjago figures. This is a really nice motorcycle as well. This one, of course, is a bit longer because of that front end. But, you know, all the cycles, almost the same length, same size, and they look awesome all together. So there you go, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Definitely pick this set up. You're not going to be disappointed. More reviews coming shortly. As you can see in the back there, we got another Ninjago Samurai Mech. That's going to be reviewed next. Thanks so much. Take care.